words. Now, again, I have come with new video lecture. We will discuss angular momentum. In rotational dynamics, we have discussed different types and different quantities, and today we will be concerned with angular momentum. Okay. We will denote this one by n. This is a vector quantity. We will denote this one by n. Angular momentum plays the same role in rotational motion as linear momentum plays in translational motion. We can say that angular momentum is a moment of linear momentum about given point or axis. This is a type of axial quantity. You know the polar vectors, axial vectors. That is a type of axial vector, not polar vectors. Axial vector means it is always perpendicular to the motion of the plane here. Okay? Angular momentum of different type of bodies would be formulated in different way. Firstly, we are talking about angular momentum. L means angular momentum of a particle. Particle means it has something mass, but it has no shape, size. It is point like body. It is like a point, but it has something mass. This is, suppose this is a point O and this is a point O, and at r position vector, linear momentum of a particle is p. P means mass into velocity. This p is always in the direction of velocity because mass has no direction. This is position vector r. It is starting from the given point or origin O and ends to the position of the particle at a particular instant r. The angle between R and P after producing this R is theta. For finding theta means angle between these two vectors, we should make them in opposite order. This R should be shifted from O to this position and then we should find out angle between them. This one is not angle between R and P. This one is angle between R and P. I hope you know this thing. If you have any problem, you will write down in comment and I will explain further if you need. Okay, R plus. So this is R, this is position vector of the particle. It has mass M, means particle has mass M and velocity V. MB or means P might be in any direction. R is always from origin to the position of the particle and angle between them is theta. By definition, this L will be given as R cross P. R cross P. This is applicable for particle. L is R cross P. Sure, this angular momentum L would not be in the direction of R or P. This is cross product between R and P. Firstly, R should be written down, then P means linear momentum. R is position vector, not P cross R. If you want to write down P cross R, you will have firstly minus sign P cross R. Because you know, vector product does not obey commutative law. It obeys anti-commutative law. So minus sign is required if you are changing the order of P and R. L, R. this will give you in scalar form as L equals to P means MV R sine theta. R sine theta. If theta is angle between R and P, sure, this is the line of P, this is point O. We will draw perpendicular from O to this line of MV, line of P, and this one will be R sine theta. This line will be R sine theta. I am this giving this OA is R sine theta. If this one is theta, this would be theta. This is perpendicular. This is R from this to this. This is R. So R sine theta will be this one. Means R sine theta is always the perpendicular distance between the linear momentum vector and point O with respect to which we are going to find out angular momentum of the body. Means this angular momentum needs only MVR, means perpendicular distance between line of linear momentum or line of velocity and point O. R perpendicular is distance between O and line of velocity. Means in this one we have mass of the particle, we have linear velocity and speed, and the perpendicular distance between O and R. This will give you magnitude of angular momentum of the particle, while in vector form we will write down R cross P. This is what. Suppose at any instant velocity V is Vxi plus Vyj plus Vzk. Ijk are unit vector along x axis, y axis and z axis. These all axes are mutually perpendicular to each other. R has position vector xi plus yj plus zk. M is mass of the body, mass of the particles. Then L equals to R cross V into M mass. M is a scalar, you can write them left or right anywhere. So we can have this L as I J. A, R is first one, so that will be written down, this component will be written down firstly, X, Y, Z, Vx, Vy, Vz. Determinant of this one, with M is multiplied into this one, will give you angular momentum. So for finding angular momentum of a particle, when velocities and position vectors are given in the form of their components, we can write it this way. And you know to solve the determinant, and we can write out.